Hey guys, so today I'm gonna basically share with you my experience of making my first $80 on Fiverr, and I'll be talking about the things that I have done right and the things that I have done wrong, and basically tell you guys how was my experience. So let's start with the things that I would recommend you guys to do. First thing is Fiverr SEO. Guys, you need to understand, like, at the end of the day, SEO will make a lot of difference when it comes to your gig ranking. And I'm gonna show you an example now what a good SEO looks like, because from my experience, for me, my gig wasn't necessarily ranking. I got some reviews from a couple of sales, and then start to get some traction, and that was the start. So let me show you a good example of basically how good SEO looks like. This page is loading, and it's really necessary, and you should do this too. Whenever you design your gig, you must always look out for people who are industry leaders, who are actually in the pages where people are like, look at this, 258, and this is in the graphic design niche, logo design niche. So let's just check out. It's level one seller, and let's check out her profile. So I can tell you, because unless your SEO is not good, you will not be able to get to this. So 11 order in queue, it's really nice. So look at these images. So these images are basically, as you can see, are all their work, and this is really important because it shows that you have done a lot of work before. And just understand one thing, and that is your customer should feel comfortable buying from you. He or she should not feel like, you know, you are an amateur on any level. So always remember this. So this is basic. Like, look at this, and I'm gonna, in this point, Fiverr SEO, I have one more po additional point with this, and that's the profile. Like, the profile, let's see, because my profile was okay and it still got 8440. So, like, for a start, it's not that bad, because my gigs were $5, so I got like how many sales? A couple, I don't remember, like $5 and stuff, and then I changed the prices too. So anyway, let's just check out her profile. So this is the profile description, and here's one more thing. Always get your description in a way that people look and, you know, your gigs should match your description, or your description should match your gigs. Both should match each other, because at the end of the day, that means you know what you are doing. Right, this description shows that you know what you're doing, and that is really important. So okay, so this was my first point. Next is basically gig presentation. So let's just, like, look at these gigs. All these gigs are in same niche, logo design. Okay, so let's just check out some other ones. So this person has got this studio tag. So I think, okay, let me check this niche too. Great quality children's book. I am reading from the URL. Okay, so let's just, as long until that thing is opening, let's just read this about the gig. I will design your logo for anything from business to events. I can pull together an excellent professional logo to be used on any print on print media or digitally. Okay, US. Now, here's one thing that I have, you know, realized, and you can say it's some sort of a sour truth. People do look at the country when they buy stuff. Like, believe it or not, they like buying from first world countries. And I'm not saying everybody, but many people, because they can communicate with them in a better way. English is their mother tongue. I am not from a first world country, but I can tell you, I feel comfortable buying from both. It depends on the, you know, talent, whoever is basically selling the product. Is he professional? Like, look at this guy. So look at this guy. Okay, so this person is from India. So as we can see, I think he is from India, so let me just see. So, okay, it doesn't matter. Look at the profile. So this profile looks extremely professional. This is, you should always take inspiration from people who are ranking, who got good SEO. So I'm gonna just save his profile. So when I basically create a gig, I can basically take some inspiration. Always take inspiration from people who are, you know, better than you in anything. It's just, that's a good mantra of life. So, okay, in life. So let's just go with the next. Okay, well, why is it not saving? I don't know. Okay, now let's talk about the pricing. Let's talk about the pricing, because my third point is pricing. Pricing is really important, because believe it or not, pricing, like low prices doesn't necessarily mean you will get more sales. Like many people think just because your prices are low, you're gonna get many sales. Like right now, as we can see, this individual has got like 5 reviews, okay? And they got some studio tag from Fiverr. This is some official tag from Fiverr, I'm guessing. So I don't know how to get these tags, because I am fairly new in comparison to these guys. So okay, so now as we can clearly see, the prices, like 2 concept minimum logo, minimal logo design, then the concept design. Now this is weird. Like as I can see from the URL, Creative Valley 9, the URL says a great quality children's books illustration, but the gig name is our studio will give a great quality logo design and business. Now that is weird. Don't do these things. Like, okay, he's ranking, I'm pretty sure he's doing pretty good for himself, but this is not good. This is like, these two should be the same. Like, why are these two different? So anyways, let me just check out the full URL. Is it the SEO? No. Okay, anyways, let's just move to the next one. Let's check out her logo design. I will logo design for anything. Now URL is the same, so SEO is on point. Pricing, like $95 for a logo, 1 revision, PNG, high resolution. $95 is a lot of money for a logo, but people are still buying. Why? Because they have a trustworthy gig profile. Like, you have to get that, and to get that gig profile, you have to take inspiration from them. And remember that, yes, country do matters, because people feel more comfortable, but your talent will always prevail. If you are talented, if you are skilled, if you are hardworking, you will be good. Now, even if you, let's say, like right now, what I'm saying is, even if like logo design, there are many logo designers on Canva, on Fiverr. There are many logo designers on Fiverr. And many people use Canva, by the way. So that's why I was thinking about Canva, because many of these designs are so easy to create if you have Canva and stuff. Like I think they are creating them themselves. They're all original designs, but many times people start these niches and they're just using these, they start these gigs and they are using Canva. So anyways, let's go to the next one. And so pricing, as I discussed, is pricing, just keep it reasonable and start with like $5-$10. If you are in a third world country, $5-$10 you can manage. In first world countries, these are normal rates. I don't know, maybe these are normal rates, I guess. So whatever the case is, let's just keep it reasonable. Whatever you find reasonable, just search. Like right now, I can show you how to basically decide for your niche how much you should charge. Okay, let's just go for, hold on, let's just click on writing in translation and let's see how much people are charging. And I'm gonna show you how to basically now translation, proofreading and editing. We are gonna go with translation. Look at how many topics you can create your gigs in. There are many topics. So anyways, translation, $10, $30, $10, $5, $100, $10. Like these studio tags, most of the time these studio tags, like translation and voiceover. So studio tag is something that Fiverr is doing to basically promote even more. So anyways, let's see, translation, $10, $5, $20. So in my opinion, you should go with $10. Go in the middle, and top rated seller is selling it for $10, so it's only right thing to do is just go with $10. Okay, so this is how you do this. If you're, let's say in your niche, most people are selling at $10, just go with 10. If most people are selling in 5, go with 5. Keep it simple, because pricing do matter, but the next point that I'm gonna go with will matter. Like the next 3 points will be basically defining factors for your success on Fiverr. So anyways, let's go to the next one. Good communication in a professional way. When it comes to requests, like I have seen people, you know, like whenever you find a request, there is a feature on Fiverr where people can just post a request and you can respond to it as a gig provider. The thing with good communication, you have to keep your communication right. If your communication is not where you know, if your English is not very good, just try to learn more. The thing is, first world country, you know, their mother tongue is English. So of course they're gonna feel more comfortable with people who can speak fluent English. Try to have at least basic knowledge of conversation and don't make grammatical mistakes. Don't make spelling mistakes. Be professional. Understand this is your job. This is like one thing that I really want you guys to always remember, that whenever you start anything like on Fiverr, any gig, or even on online business or anything, this is your business. This is take it a little bit seriously. And understand it's competition, and you to be above competition, these little things matters. If you can speak fluent English, if you can communicate properly, people will prefer you. Okay, so this is the one. Now respond to the request. Next point is responding to the request. Those requests that I was basically mentioning on my last point. Requests are basically when people post a particular custom thing they want, and then you can respond to it as a seller. So whatever you want to do, whenever you respond to requests, like you can respond to request from your selling dashboard and just check out what people want. If let's say I want logo design, I will post a request, and then you can respond as a logo designer from your logo designing niche, and you can just check out what they want, and you can give them your, you know, code. So whenever you respond to any request, and if you are into, like, particularly if you are into a niche related to programming and tech. Okay, if you are into tech and programming, software development, if you are, like, although you are providing the niche, but you don't know everything about it, make sure that you have full knowledge, like, what they want. Like, let's say you now you know what they want. Do your research before typing a word to the customer. Do your research. At least take half an hour before, like, do your research. Like, okay, this is what they want. These are the keywords. These are the things that they might ask for. And you already have those things ready. That will give you way more, you know, preference in the eyes of the customer. Let's just go for the next one. And next is reviews. Now, next, reviews is probably one of the most tricky part when it comes to Fiverr. So what do you do? What do you do for reviews? So I basically contacted a couple of my friends before I basically got some traction. So for some traction, you need some of the purchases from outside. Fiverr is not gonna promote your gig as is. It's just not now. Maybe if your gig is extremely unique and you have all these above points, like your SEO is good, great, your profile is great, gig presentation is on point, pricing is good, communication is really good, and you respond to a request after researching, maybe you will get, like, there is a high possibility, like 60-70% chances that you will get that gig. But reviews will matter so much that it's extremely, extremely necessary. Like, look at this, even with 8, 110, 17, 274, 108, 16, you can rank with 10 reviews. So there are many different ways to get reviews. Maybe you can just tell your friend to buy your stuff and just start reviewing that, and then adjust the pricing accordingly. And there are groups, and I'm not gonna be talking about this a lot, but there are places where you can just go and exchange reviews. And in my opinion, they are neither good nor bad. because at the end of the day, sometimes talented people do need, you know, some traction. Just because you're talented doesn't mean people, the world owe you this, or Fiverr owe you this, because Fiverr got many talented people. So getting some reviews like that doesn't hurt, and it's beneficial for both parties. And I will put some, you know, links and stuff for a blog post where I mentioned a couple of those groups. You can join them and just start getting some reviews if you want to. And whatever you do, just understand it's a time-taking process. For 8440, it took me like at least 2 months, so I don't even remember. The thing is that I created the gigs and then I forgot, and then I was like just doing my thing, and I got some reviews from my friends. I basically told them to buy some of my stuff before the sales. These like maybe I got like two purchases from people who I know from outside, and then all the other ones are from you. So you can negate 10 of 10 bucks from that if you want to, but in all reality, money is money. And then I got traction, and now I'm here. So you have to just do the necessary amount of work. Make sure that you are sincere with this thing. Take it as a business. Always remember, this is your business. Your life is going to be dependent. If you are doing this full time, then you are going to succeed. If you are doing this part time, there is no way. So do everything in your power to know. Like, let's just look at a couple of these profiles. So let's just, before we end this video, I'm going to just look at a couple of more profiles so I can see. No satisfaction, money back guarantee, consultation. Now, consultation is a really good one. Always, you know, try to make a customer more comfortable that they can always contact you, they can always talk to you, respond quickly if you can respond. And there is a feature on Canva where you can go on vacation, or you can just respond quickly as you can. When you are working, like sit in front of the computer, sit with your mobile phone. And this guy is from UK. Okay, so this guy's from UK. Industry designs. Okay, let me see. No satisfaction, money back guarantee, free premium plugin, early drop shipping, DV. Interesting. Very interesting profile, to say the least. Student age. So this person is a teacher. London based. Look at this. So this person, they're already mentioning like he's London based, UK. The profile is so well made. Like, you have to understand. And if you are from a third world country, don't worry about these things. Just provide quality. Do what you can. Do what you can, guys. Don't worry about these things. And there are people who are from third world country making a lot of money with Canva. They got like 11 orders in queue. And try to be unique. Like, look at this. Though, let's just say student age, development. As a programmer, he knows a lot of things. Like, free premium installation comes with first and fifth lesson. So look at this. So this is premium plugin. He's providing premium plugins with it too. So people will be like, okay, so if I'm giving like, let's say, okay, what was any level 600 bug design consultation, so it's 350 bucks, right? It's a lot of money, I'm not gonna lie, it's a lot of money. So 5 lessons, 60 minutes, okay. But then you get all these free plugins, so people will be more enticed to buy these things. So these are the little things that matters when it comes to creating a great, you know, design, great gig. So one second, you know, how much is it's 20 minutes. So support in IT is a great gig too, if you are like good tech savvy guy. Because many people, you have to just find some unique gigs. So for me, music was my thing, and I am good at audio, you know, processing and stuff, and I can basically do a couple of things that not many people can, like cleaning up the audio and all these things. So now you basically know my gig. I basically clean up audio. So anyways, so whatever the case is, just try to be unique. Because the one thing I've learned is the more unique you are, you have more opportunity to rank in any keyword. Because at the end of the day, competition is only high when something is simple. Try to master difficult things. Try to master things that you can, you know, you that not many people can do, and then compete in the pricing, then compete in everything. You must have that competitive spirit. At the end, this is like the one thing that has helped me change my mindset a lot, like to have some competitive spirit, and not in a negative way. I have respect for all these gig providers, all these people, but at the end of the day, either they are gonna get a gig, or I'm gonna get a gig if they are on the same topic, right? So it's better that I get that gig. That's why I'm not showing you my gigs. So nobody can just come and just try to compete with me for no reason. Just find your own gig. Do your own thing, right? So these are the things that I want you guys to remember and apply that. And I promise you, you will be making a lot of good money if you really give your 100%. So apply these tactics and I'm pretty sure you will be making you'll be getting a lot of gigs, making a lot of money. So that's all for this. And thanks for watching. Thank you.